All right, we're back with more Sons of the Forest. It's 5 in the morning, by the way. 5 o'clock-ish in the morning's time. And we've got water up here. Let's grab these. Calm down, Kevin. Calm down, son. Let's have the food. Eat the food. Eat you the breakfast. Eat you the breakfast. Drink from our pot of water. What is on the agenda today? I think we can finish up a good portion. What is that? Deer head. Yeah, maybe I should put that up. Let's put our deer head away, huh? There we go. We already have 3 of them. Yeah. I need to go get another moose. We need to go on a walkabout. maybe we'll put another one over here. Yeah, let's put another one over here. Build a thing. Is it storage or decor? I don't know. It's not traps. It's storage. Decor, I'm imagining. I'm thinking, I don't remember where this stuff goes. I have no memory of this place. We'll put you in the middle. Right about. Shaw. There you go. You have a lovely day, sir. You can stare. You can have a stare down contest for the remainder of the game. All right. What are we doing? I'm gonna have Kelvin gather stone over here. Wherever he went to. He's running around someplace. Yeah. Who knows? Who knows what the man does? The man's a free agent. Come out of nowhere. Usually you need to do something to get somebody's thumbs up. Hey, you did a great job on that project. Thumbs up. Hey, you started working out, you know, good job. Hey, you punched that guy in the nose. Good job. You know, that kind of thing. Virginia just gives you random thumbs up. She's a random kind of gal. That's all there is to it. She doesn't... I don't think she wants to be put into a category, you know? I'm not going to give my thumbs up when you do something well. I'm just going to give it randomly. So you don't know what it is that you've done. Maybe she's giving us a thumbs up because she's feeling good. That's possible. All right, let's go get Kelvin. Come here, son. I know it's ya. Follow me. Okay. And let's go to Hall. And I'll have you pick up stones over here. You little shithead, come here. Let me walk away a little bit. Guy. Alright, how about you get some stones and fill the holders? we're going over here. We have things to do over here. We have, let me see what I'm doing here before I do anything. All right, we're filling this in. Got it. Okay. How is everyone doing today? Everyone doing fine? I hope you're doing fine. I hope you're doing well, good, and all that. And all that at a... Yeah, I gritted that. Okay. I've slept, you know, sleeping. Bring me something yummy for the tummy. I don't know if your tummy is yummy. A lot of acid in there. I heard him coming. I heard your stupid butt head. Oh, yeah? You need to wear shin guards, sir. Very little good to protect your head if your feet aren't protected, your legs aren't protected. Thank you. Let's go grab these logs out so I can do that corner. There. There you go. Would you bring me a stick? Look at you. Oh my god, your smile. And it's gotta work on that smile for her. Okay? It's creepy. It's creepy. I prefer she not smile. Imagine waking up in the morning and seeing that smile above your head. You know something bad's about ready to happen. You just get the gut feeling like something bad is about ready to happen. And I'm not going to like the end result of this. Yeah, that's what it reminds me of. I like these logs over here. They're close enough to the area, but they're far enough away that they're not an eyesore. And they're kind of out of the way too. That's really nice. It's a good spot for them. I really like building in this game. It's so much fun. You know, it's kind of boring a little bit. It's not boring. It's just it's kind of, it allows your mind to wander. You're not trying to do 50 things at once. It allows you to allows you to zone out a little bit, do a project. But my problem is I start zoning out and I forget I'm recording and actually doing this for you guys, and I don't have any commentary. What are you doing? I'm thinking about pink elephants flying across a lavender sky. No, not really, but that's an example, right? That is an example. I don't think about pink elephants. Not anymore, anyway. What you got? Bring me some berries. Kill blackberries. All right, well, let's just use these. Now, what's also really nice about the game, building in this game, and what's also really nice is that you can build and do commentary pretty well, because you're not constantly being attacked by cannibals all the time. You're not in situations where you have to, you know, focus all the time. There are some games that I play, you know, there's some games that you that are just mentally exhausting to play, because you're focusing so much on the game. And I try to comment on some of that stuff. Let me comment about my thought process of what I'm doing while I'm trying to combat 55 zombies coming in on my head. Remember the last episode that I made for State of Decay? It was a I would call it a speed-ish run, where I was using all the tools that I had accumulated over the game to basically, you know, go after all the plague hearts in one go. That was, I think, an hour and a half, or an hour and 45 minutes. I was mentally exhausted after that. It was mental. So many things going on, and I was pretty much quiet the whole time I was playing. Completely in the zone. It was a lot of fun. Now, games like, I think one of my favorite tactical games, is XCOM, the original Long War, with the Long War mod on it. That's one of my favorite tactical games. You generally have to think three or four moves ahead. It's basically, you know, chess game if you've never played it before. It's basically a chess game. And you have to think three, four, five moves ahead before you start doing things. And then you got to start, you know, and then you don't know what enemies are on the field when you zone in, when you go into the area. And yeah, you're just looking at the map and planning out your shots. But one of the things that I like about it is that it's turn-based. And it's not like you have to make a split-second decision on where you're going to put people and how you're going to put people. I guess I just filled that up already. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to finish the, I was doing a impossible run, Iron Man, or no, I didn't play Iron Man, I was playing Bronze-ish Man, because you're playing, if you're playing with a mod, you don't want to play on Iron Man. What am I, it's a freaking flipper, you don't want to play on Iron Man if you're playing with a mod, a modded version of pretty much any game, because it's obviously not part of the game, so the game can break, and I've had it break before when playing on Iron Man saves, but I was playing like honest, I'm not going to do this, and we're gonna load the last save, we're gonna be using the save, anyway, so I was going through the doing the impossible, and I got to it was right after the base attack from the aliens, and that's when I bought a new computer, and I forgot to transfer my files over. And I took the old computer, and well, the other old gaming machine that I had, and formatted its hard drive and cleaned it up, you know, like you do, to make it into my second PC for rendering and all that kind of stuff. Can we get over there? Yes, we can. If we try. There we go. Have to take that down. I have to put a wall here. But that's a fun game. But it's like playing a game of chess. It is mentally. It's mentally exhausting. I love chess. I'm not very good at it, though. It's because I don't play a lot. Thank you. Now, I remember when, of course, this was back in the day when the, it was IBM, built the first game, the first program to actually, that could actually beat a human in the game of chess. And that was touted as some miraculous thing. And, you know, I wasn't very impressed with that. Well, it's a computer. It can calculate 7,000 moves in advance. Of course it's going to be able to beat a human. It can run all the permutations when a human moves a... Not that impressive, but some people thought it was impressive. You know, can computers beat humans in intellectual endeavors like chess or checkers? Of course they can. It's like it's calculating 3,000 moves in advance, and you're, you know, trying to think 10 or 15. How do you beat that? How do you beat that? But am I worried about AI taking over the world? Nope. Nope. Not at all. Will it take jobs? Yes, it will. It will take people's jobs, but we've been doing that for years. Making things easier on ourselves. You just have to adapt to the new reality. The reality is that you don't need, you don't need horses and carriages anymore when you have cars. Learn to build a better car than your competition. Learn to maintain a car. That's I think where people have a lot of problems. They just don't adapt to new technologies. And it makes don't learn the new technology, how are you going to be able to use it? You get a distinct disadvantage. But I'm not saying that the old things are better, or the new things are better than the old things. Because some older things are better than newer things. Technology also frees us up to do other things as well. I certainly would not want to hand wash my clothes. Washer and dryer. Yes, please. Yes, please. I mean, honestly, would any of you want to go back to the days? Some of you may not even remember this. I mean, some of you are, you know, in your 20s and such, but I'm a little bit older than that. But, you know, Amazon. Let's get rid of Amazon. Being able to order things online and not having to leave the comfort of your home to get, you know, something that you want. It just frees you up. It frees your time up. Let's see, let me go online and buy, you know, some of this and some of that, some of this. It's going to take me 15 minutes to do that. Or I have to get in my car and I have to go to 10 different locations to buy the things that I want. And I have to price shop, you know. Take it 3 or 4 hours to go buy some pencils and notebooks and paper. No. No, thank you. I don't want to leave my house. There's people out there. Are you kidding me? I don't want to talk to you and stuff. let's get our old cross out here. Where you going? Where'd you guys go? Oh, we can't do it from distance. Can't have any fun things around here. There we go. Didn't like it. Alright, well, we're gonna have to do this way, I guess. Burn. Come on over here, guys. Oh my gosh, hitboxes, please. Choppy, choppy, the things that we need. All right, let's go sleepy by time, because Mr. Man here is about ready to pass out from sheer exhaustion. There's another one around here somewhere, but I'm not really too worried about it either. We get all the things mm-hmm. when we need them. Yeah, I know. You. Come here. Come on. Around the corner. Let's go. I would like to do another XCOM run on Impossible. I don't know how many times I've played it. So much fun. It's so much fun. Helioveria. Would you get me some other ones? Some different ones? What I should do here in our room here is get rid of like a couple of these and build shelves. Like get rid of these two or something and then build shelves on the wall. Once they're done, we can just take the fish and put them on the shelves. We'll do that. Not today, though. Today we're working on other things. Do 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 do. get some more skulls. I keep forgetting to do that. This is a good spot for him. He's filled these up pretty quick. Oh, don't stand in front, Virginia. I was wondering if they changed that. I thought she ducked her head at one time. She ran right into that. Can't be held accountable. I won't be held accountable for other people's actions. Not this again. This thing's so stupid. I'm gonna build a trap over here, helicopter trap. Slug she's putting into him. Hey, Virginia, come on, over here. Shoot him. Put some rounds in that guy. This is what I mean by saying the the dudes, the mutants in this game are not scary. They're just more troublesome than they're worth. They're just troublesome creatures. Solutions to kill these guys. The solution to kill these guys is, you know, you want to use explosives. But now that you can't make explosives anymore, once you've looted an area, the stuff does not respawn. Not as far as I've found, anyway. Just like, I'm not doing this anymore. Okay? My shotgun ammo doesn't respawn. My pistol ammo doesn't respawn. So whatever you got, you got. You're like, nah, I don't want to use my ammo for that thing. And if I can't get more, then I don't want to fight it. But, you know, in the forest, you could go down and get more dynamite if you needed to. It respawned. But now, not so much. So it's not as fun, you know? It takes away from the fun. There's a limit on your offensive capabilities at that point. Or if you're playing in the early game, obviously, and you want to complete the game, well, why would you use your limited supply of... Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know, right? You wouldn't want to use your limited supply of C4 to fight enemies that are outside when you want to progress into the story. Now, if you're a new player and you don't know what's ahead of you, generally in most RPG games, you want to save your good stuff for later. For the big bosses, right? I don't want to spend my ammunition on leg, finger, hand, person. I don't know what's coming up later in the game. Probably something big, awful, and terrible. So let's save it. I haven't shot crossbows at this guy, so I don't know how effective it is. Slinky Monster takes, what, 6 or 8 crossbows? Crossbow bolts? I don't know how many arrows it would take to kill this one of these things. Because I haven't really tried it. maybe I'll try, maybe I'll try a crossbow on these things, see how it does. Well, I think I took all my crossbow bolts and put them in the storage areas. And I've yet to go get more. Yeah, I've been here already, haven't I? Joke's on me. Thank you. Let's see here. It's like three pieces of rope over here. Where's the other one? Where is the others? There it is. These are for use. These aren't for decorations. We'll be using these. Tape. I think I filled the tape up. Yeah, we are full on tape. There's 50 tape. Rope. Was I going to put rope in here? Yes, eventually. But let's go to the other place. A lot of food we have. Should put a shelf for mystery meat. A lot of this stuff is, these trees are starting to come back. Very slowly, though. As it should be. It should grow overnight. What's it going to do next? Oh, yeah. Let me go over here. Somehow those are getting destroyed, even up high. Grease. Can't make any more. What's this one? Nope. Space. All right, I'm gonna go pull this zip line. I'm going to leave that one over there. I'm probably going to use it at some point. Am I going to use that? Not really. We're starting to expand out into this area, so... pull it. If I need it, we'll bring it back. And... we're going to need these at some point. Yeah, let me put this right here. For now. Okay. Okay, and then we fill this in tomorrow. Looks good. We'll start the game, play a little bit more, build a little bit more. Interested in bringing this out, like all that firewood, making a big firewood place. I've been shooting my is that probably that stupid leg monster. Been bashing. These are growing. Aloe vera. I think I put firewood in there. I think we're gonna put horsetail. What is it for the healing mix, health mix? There's a health plus. I don't remember what it was. It's not that. I won't even show you what you can make with the items. It's ridiculous. You can't even see what you can make out of the item. That's silly, man. It's silly. Chicory, sevenberry, blueberry, yarrow. Put another yarrow in. Yarrow should go here. I was saving that for something, wasn't it? I don't remember what I was doing. I don't remember things. Things have no meaning in me anymore. My brain is not working as well. Any more fishies in here? Okay. too fishy for tomorrow. And we got water. Yep. No empty pots. Yeah. Getting things done. Getting the things done. This might take another 2 or 3 days of working. Then I think after we're done with this, we'll take a little break from big building projects and work on expanding the town after that's built. That's typically how I do things. One big build and then we do some stuff in the town. I gotta get rid of the spider webs. That's a lot of supplies. That they have surfaced well, though. But that, my friends, is going to do it for this episode. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. And we'll see you next time.